Hi guys, my name is Lita, this is Let's Play Thief Gold. The mission in question is return to the cathedral, and it is going to be a longer video again, a longer mission, I mean. My objectives are really simple. I have to grab the eye and to leave the cathedral area. I don't even have to steal a certain amount of loot, which is always slightly suspicious, I must say. But it's justified, because Constantine told us that he would give us, I don't know, 100,000 gold or something for the eye. Yeah, let's do it. And I start out not by entering the cathedral in the usual means, which would be to use my talismans onto those things here. You just have to place the appropriate talisman into their hands, but by collecting another bunch of skulls and rib cages. Well, this is going to take a little while, sorry about that, but I will try to talk. I may take some breaks during this recording. This is because I'm actually done with a nasty flu of sorts at the moment, and I probably shouldn't even play this here. I think I need another skull. But yeah, I thought I should do it anyway. Need one more skull. Is this? No, I just thought that there would have been a fire arrow. Oh, maybe I should say it. If this here would be a thief Dark Project, not Thief Gold, then you could just really do it, this mission, in a funny way. You could just enter the cathedral, steal the eye, enter the cathedral, block the door with a skull, this one that I'm stacking right now, for instance. The door would then be blocked and not be able to close itself anymore. And that would mean that you could just leave then. Now, this here is Thief Gold, and the devs didn't like it that the players could just leave the mission like that, so it is a bit more complicated. As apparently I'm having issues and difficulties right now to stack objects. I am blaming the fever that I have, but it could also just be because I suck, of course. Was this high enough? I doubt it. But it worked, okay. So, what we are doing again is to enter the cathedral from here rather than through the front gate. This is because I read in various of the missions in between the Haunted Cathedral and this year, that the talismans, that certain people seem to think that the talismans are really worth something. So I think that Garrett may be able to sell them off again afterwards for a nice price. This is my reasoning why I'm doing this here right now. So I am a bit unsure. No, we have to do it the hard way and take some damages, but never mind. It does hurt a little bit now, but not too badly. Ouch, yeah, here you go. So, contrary to the haunted...
Are you blind? Have you come all this way, only to leave me as I fall within your grasp?
Yes, honey, this is exactly what I am doing. What I was about to say is that contrary to the Haunted Cathedral, this time the city part is cut out and the cloister is existent instead. Now, here. I will explain what I am doing. As soon as it's a bit quieter again. What I will be doing is that I will turn on the power in the basement of the cathedral. Then I will run around and collect a bunch of crates from in here and put them out there. And then we are going to explore explore the cloister this is, because I'm so much spiteful, actually. Yeah, this note here, this is about a novice who found a ghost in the graveyard yesterday. This note must be from before the cataclysm that happened, which was probably related to the eye, but more about that later on, I think. Also, a certain brother Murus is being mentioned, who was buried last week. Okay, I think I can do it in a really easy way by just leaving the lights turned out, but I want to do it the hard way, and so I'm going to switch the lights on. So that you can see something. I'm going to suffer again, just for my audience. What? They are randomly moving around, turning by 180 degrees every once in a while. So that it's harder to avoid them, of course. Yeah, let's visit this here. This leads to the wine cellar, and I think because I switched on the lights, we can actually see what's going on in there. I did a scouting trip again of this mission before this real recording session, and I think it was just too dark in here. A dead body called Brother Renault. I just leave him there. Look at that hat. Okay. And now we need to switch the power on. Okay, the zombie has somewhat seen me, but not totally. This is taking a bit longer now because the lights are on and I'm more careful than I would otherwise be. Also, it's being noisy. I think he has good hearing, but that shouldn't matter. I am just doing this to show off Garrett's amazing spine. He can just lean around a table like that. Yeah. Oh, he's coming here. Okay, this was one part of turning on the power. There's another switch in the room ahead, which I also have to pull. And that's it for the basement. I am skipping out on the toilet because it's just a toilet, nothing special about it. Okay, we are now in for a really exciting part. I am going to drag 5 crates from the top floor down into the cloister garden, and then we are visiting the cloister itself. All the buildings of it that you have seen in the cutscene, where the map was shown for a short while. I don't think that there's actually anyone here who could hear me roaming around like that. I know that there's a zombie on the first floor sometimes, and maybe he can hear me if I'm messing about too badly. But I don't think that I ever ran into problems here, so it's not necessary to sneak, even though the floors are of the nasty, noisy type. Yeah. I'm doing this here step by step because I can't open doors while carrying a crate in my hands, and the doors, if you haven't noticed it yet, close shut behind Garrett after a certain amount of seconds, or after a certain amount of after walking past the trigger line or something like that. See? Just try to shut itself. There's usually time enough to get two crates out of there, then you have to manipulate the door again. Okay, here we go now. Watch out, or listen out, for the amazing sound effect. Whenever walking across that line, it is doing this breathing effect. I mean, it's a nice sound effect, but a bit repetitive over time. Dumping them here for now. Oops. I think the horn got stuck. This is bad news, because I have to get past them. Yeah, close. I want to see that my crates are safe. Okay, yeah, the horn. I will do a quick save, quick load maneuver to get him free, I think, because I have to get past him. And that didn't work, eh? Okay, he needed two reloads. I'm going inside of the cloister now, skipping out on a water arrow in the pool of the garden, because I don't really need more water arrows here. This is bad news. A zombie approaching me right there. All the foes in here, or almost all of them, are moving on random patrol patterns. This really makes it more annoying. Not particularly more difficult, just more annoying, but that to a very high degree. We are inside of St. Hiora now, and I did hear the horn approach, but I think that I have time enough to walk in here anyway, to get my precious ways.